Welcome to Edumon Tutorials. I am Shave Chilagalla. I am an instructor of M2. This video is about Unit 2's first topic, eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a matrix. First, let's discuss about eigenvalues. Eigenvalues are represented using lambda. Let there be a square matrix A of order n and I, unit matrix of order n. We'll be forming a matrix A minus lambda I. Then we'll be applying det and equating it to 0. So, after expanding the determinant, we'll be getting equation in the form of minus 1 whole power n lambda n plus k1 lambda power n minus 1 plus so on kn equal to 0. We'll be finding roots for this equation. The roots of this equation are called as eigenvalues. Let's discuss about eigenvectors. Eigenvectors, basically, they are denoted using x. Let lambda be the eigenvalue of A, then a non-zero matrix of order n by 1, that is column matrix, exists such that A minus lambda I into x is equal to 0 is called an eigenvector or latent vector. Properties of eigenvalues. These are some important properties. First, square matrix A and its transpose will have same eigenvalues. Next, idempotent matrix eigenvalues are 0 or unity. Idempotent matrix is nothing but the matrix which satisfies the condition A is equal to A square. Next, sum of eigenvalues of matrix is basically equal to trace. Trace is nothing but sum of diagonal elements. Next, product of eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to determinant of that matrix. If A has lambda as eigenvalue, then A inverse has 1 by lambda. Let there be n eigenvalues of a matrix A, then A power m will have eigenvalues as mth power for all the eigenvalues. Let's look into this example on how to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a matrix. Here, A is a matrix of order 3 by 3. First, let's find eigenvalues. So, let's take characteristic equation A minus lambda I is equal to 0. Det of A minus lambda equal to 0. Let's find this determinant of this A minus lambda I. Let's expand this determinant. We have this equation at last. So let's find roots for this equation. These three are the roots for this equation. So these are the eigenvalues for the matrix A. Let's find eigenvectors. Let's take this equation A minus lambda I into x equal to null matrix. Here, x is the eigenvector which contain x1, x2, x3 as components. As we have already know, x is a column matrix, so eigenvector is a matrix of order 3 by 1. Let's multiply these two matrices and equate it to null matrix. Let's equate these two matrices. So we'll get three equations. Now, in order to find eigenvectors, we need to substitute eigenvalues one by one. So first let's take lambda equal to 1, and we'll be substituting this value in these three equations. We'll get equations as we'll get these three equations. In order to find component values, I mean x1, x2, x3 values, we need to use Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule is simple. We'll be writing this form x1, we'll be applying negative sign for x2 and x3. In the denominator, we'll write determinant here. In order to find x1 value, we need to do determinant for the coefficients of x2 and x3. First, let's select any of two equations. Here, we are selecting these two equations. Now, for x1, we need to take these coefficient values from these two equations and we need to find the determinant for it. Similarly, for x2, we need to take x1, x3 coefficients from these two equations. Similarly for x3. Now, let's find its determinant values. Let's divide the denominator with the help of 21. Zero by anything is equal to zero, so nothing changes. So for lambda equal to 1, the eigenvector will be 1 0 0. This will be the eigenvector for lambda equal to 1. Similarly, let's find eigenvectors for lambda equal to 2 and 3. Sorry, for minus 2 and minus 3, we need to find the eigenvectors since these are the eigenvalues for the matrix A. Let's substitute this lambda equal to minus 3 in the equations we got. These are equations, so let's use Cramer's rule. Let's choose these two equations. These will be the eigenvectors when lambda equal to 3, sorry, minus 3. So let's find eigenvectors for lambda equal to minus 2. Then substitute lambda equal to minus 2 in the above equations. These are three equations. Let's apply Cramer's rule. So, let's find the determinant values. Let's divide denominators with 6. So, we'll get eigenvectors as 2, minus 3 and 0 and lambda equal to minus 2. So that's it guys. We'll find eigenvalues and eigenvectors using this method. If you have any doubts, ask in the comment section below. Let's discuss Cayley-Hamilton theorem and its application in the next video.